What if you could make your electric bike lighter, faster, have more range, make it more resistant to flats, and you didn't have to add anything to the bike? In fact, you would actually remove something instead. What I'm talking about is a tubeless conversion of your tire. And in case you don't know what that is, that's okay. That's exactly what this video is for. I wanna explain to you not only why you would wanna have a tubeless setup on an electric bike, but how to do it on the Bolton e-bike's Blackbird. Now, I mentioned a few things. I said lighter, faster, more range, and more puncture resistant. Let me explain what I mean by that. Lighter definitely is a benefit because fat bike tubes in particular are fairly heavy. If you can remove the tube from each tire, you can save a few pounds off of your bike with really no downside. So lighter, definitely something that we can do. In fact, we can weigh the bike before and after this conversion to see how much weight we actually save. Now, second, I said faster, and that's because a tubeless setup has less rolling resistance. And it may be a little bit odd to think about, but as the tire actually rolls and rotates, at the very bottom of the tire, it's going to compress with every rotation. So at some point, the tire and the tube inside is always being compressed down and then expanding back out. And there's a certain amount of friction when that happens. When you remove the tube, you actually remove a bunch of the friction for the tire rolling. And so the tire will actually roll easier without the tube inside than with a tube in there. So less rolling resistance means there's two different benefits. One, in theory, you should be able to go slightly faster on a certain amount of power. And that's why tubeless setups are very popular and common in racing type bicycles, not just e-bikes. E-bikes, I think it's more rare. As well, if you have less rolling resistance, that of course is going to mean more range, which is very important on an electric bike. Finally, I mentioned flat resistance. Well, how is a tubeless setup more resistant to flats than something that has a tube in it? When you have a tube, there's a few different ways to get a flat. One of them gets eliminated completely, and that's called a pinch flat. If you hit your tire hard on something, like on a curb or on a big rock or a root, it's possible that you compress the tire enough that the tube actually pinches itself, and that's what they call a pinch flat, or when I was growing up, we always called them snake bites because you sometimes get two little holes in one spot, and that's a sign that you definitely had a pinch flat. If you don't have a tube, you can eliminate those types of flats altogether. One of the benefits to a tubeless setup, because you can eliminate pinch flats, is that you can run tubeless tires at lower pressure. So if you're riding in sand or snow or any sort of loose conditions, you can let more air out of the tire and not have the tire go flat because of a pinch flat than you could with a tubed setup. The other types of flats you can get are typically from thorns and nails and screws and everything. A tubeless setup isn't going to prevent everything, but it does actually help against thorns. One of the things that you need in a tubeless setup is a little bit of a sealant, and that keeps any tiny little air gaps sealed up. It kind of doubles as a flat protection because if you get a thorn in the tire and you remove it, the sealant that's inside the tire is gonna plug that hole up and seal it back up and keep most of your air inside the tire where it belongs. One of the benefits that I've discovered as well is that sometimes tubeless setups are easier to repair if you do get a flat. So if you have a tire like this one, and let's say a nail or a screw goes through it, something big enough to where the sealant can't seal it up, there are plugs you can get that actually go in from the outside of the tire. So you don't remove the wheel from the bike, you don't remove the tire or anything. You can actually plug it from the outside, pump it back up, and then continue on your ride. And I've seen people do this in a matter of seconds. Now, the Bolton e-bike's Blackbird comes with tubeless ready tires and tubeless ready rims. That makes it a lot easier to make this conversion happen. If you don't have tubeless ready tires and rims, I've seen people do a conversion. I can't guarantee, however, if it will work. And some of the techniques I'm gonna show in this video may not work at all. This video is intended if you have tubeless ready fat bike rims and tires. The Blackbird also comes with some sealant. This is what's gonna go inside the tire and the rim to keep all of the air inside where we want it. This is tubeless ready tape that you can buy online or at a local bike shop. And if you can't find this or don't have access to this for some reason and you need some, the good news is there's an alternative you can find at your local hardware store. I've seen many people online, reputable bike tool companies, their own videos, where instead of using the official tubeless tape, they're actually just using standard Gorilla tape that you can buy at your local hardware store. So just know that if you need some tubeless tape or a replacement, this is an easy alternative that you can easily get your hands on. The other thing that the Blackbird comes with is a new valve stem. This one has a rubber grommet at the bottom, and this is what you use instead of the valve stem that is normally on your tube. Finally, to make things easier, in the Blackbird boxes, we always include a valve stem adapter. That's just in case you don't have a pump that can pump up a Presta valve like this one. This adapts this to a Schrader. That's the same as on most bicycles and most cars, so most pumps can connect to this. Let's go ahead and get this converted over to our tubeless setup. We're gonna remove the cap on the valve stem, and then there is a second nut on a Presta valve that you just loosen up. It doesn't come all the way off, and then when you press it, that lets all the air out. Once you've got all the air out, you need to break the bead, but make sure to only do that on one side of the tire. So on the tubeless rims, there's a special little groove all the way around the inside edge that holds the tire in place. And we want to pop that out of place, but only on one side. That's very important, otherwise this will be much more difficult later. Once you've got the bead loose, at this point you may need a couple of tire irons. I would highly recommend it. Go ahead and pop the bead completely off and outside the edge on one side of the rim. Remember that we're leaving the bead on the opposite side intact. The Presta valves have a small nut that holds the valve up tight against the rim. You'll need to remove that, and then you can go ahead and pull the tube all the way out. Set this aside, we don't need it anymore. Now I'm gonna show you what you need to do if you don't have the tubeless tape installed. So this right here, this rim strip, you can see where it says Sun Ringle. That is just a rim strip. It's just the liner to cover the holes in the rim. That is not the tubeless tape that we need. Now, if you have the tubeless tape already installed right here, you can skip these next couple of steps of putting the tape on and pressing it into place. If you don't have the tubeless tape on, you need to break the bead on the other side of the tire and get the tire completely off. And then you're gonna take the tape and put it all the way around the entire rim, and make sure it goes all the way up to the edges on both sides. Also, if you're using the Gorilla tape method instead of the tubeless tape, make sure that the tape overlaps nicely and that there's no way that air can get in between any of the gaps. Once you have the tape on, you're gonna do something a little bit counterintuitive, but it's gonna make this a lot easier later. You want to actually put the tire back on and reinstall and reinflate the tube. What this is gonna do is push all of this tape down into all of the little nooks and crannies, make sure it's seated nicely, and it's gonna get one of our beads on the tire seated back into place. Now that we have the tube back on and the tire is on the rim, you wanna inflate it fully so that the bead is seated on both sides. And you're gonna hear it pop into place. You also wanna watch along the edge and just make sure you don't see any gaps here. If you do, or if the tire is lopsided or a little bit uneven, what you can do is take a spray bottle with some soapy water and just spray it right along the edge of the rim and the bead, and that will help it to slide into place. Now that the bead is secure on both sides, we know that the tape is going to be pressed down into place. We can kind of go back to step one of this video. Let the air out of the tire, pull the tube out, but make sure when you pull the tube out, only break one side of the bead, because this time that one side is going to stay. We'll get the tube pulled all the way out. And as a tip, you may want to save this and keep it in your spare parts bag, because if you ever do get a flat on your tubeless setup that you can't fix, a simple quick fix is to just throw a tube back in. Now you want to take the new valve stem that has the rubber grommet at the bottom and insert that into the hole in your rim. Now I did poke a hole in the tubeless tape right there. If you haven't done that already, you'll need to take a sharp knife or something with a nice round point is ideal. And just poke that through, nut on the inside of the rim, and tighten that all the way down. Now comes the sealant. You're just gonna pour this directly into the tire. An alternative way to do this is actually to remove the core of the valve stem, and you can put it in through the valve if you'd like. But this is the simplest way to do it on a fat tire, is just pour it right in. At this point, you want to go ahead and put the bead back into the inside of the rim. Just be mindful when you're moving things around that you have a big puddly pool of sealant at the bottom of the tire, and we don't want that to spill out. Once you've got the bead back on, now it's time to put some air back in the tire. This may take a fair amount of pressure. So if you have an air compressor, probably gonna be the easiest solution. Doing it with a hand pump or a small portable pump may or may not work. Just be aware that there may be mixed results. An air compressor, if you've got one, is gonna have the best chances of success. Make sure that when you inflate that the tire gets seated back into that bead. So any little gaps like this need to go away. Now you've got air in the tire, sealant in the tire, but we need to make sure the sealant is getting into all the little nooks and crannies inside the tire, where the bead is, where the valve stem is. So what you want to do is take the tire like this and just kind of rotate it around. You see when you pour the sealant in how liquidy it is and how it can get everywhere, which is what it's supposed to do. So you rotate it around this way, and then you can flip it over and rotate it around the other way. You may have to reinflate the tire a few times over the next several hours, even possibly a few days, as the sealant gets into every little spot it needs to get to. And then the other thing, of course, you can do is take the tire and roll it this way. And you can do that with it on the bike. And you can see already that I've lost a little bit of my pressure from when we first filled it up. So we'll just keep that sealant moving around. Just check it every few days. The other thing to be aware of for tubeless tires is that they do tend to have just very, very slow gradual leaks all the time. Meaning if you go to ride your bike after a month or two, don't be surprised if the pressure is a little bit lower. That's perfectly normal and acceptable. You just wanna pump your tires up a little bit and then go for your ride. Now that the tubeless conversion is done, let's test out some of the benefits that I talked about. I definitely want to do a top speed run and see, is there a noticeable change in top speed with tubeless tires or not? But before we get to that, one of the easy things that we can test is the weight. All we need to do is weigh this bike and one that has not had the tubeless conversion done to it. So off camera, I've got a completely stock with tubes installed bike. Let's throw that on the scale and see how much it weighs first. I've got just under 29 pounds for the front half of the bike. We can weigh the front half and then the back half of the bike and just add those together. Just about 29 pounds, maybe a hair under on the front wheel. And we're measuring about 39 on the back half. Not the most accurate test, but that's given me about 68 pounds, which sounds about right with all the accessories and everything installed. Let's see what the tubeless version weighs. What about 27 and a half pounds? And I'm getting about 38 and a half there. So I'd say we've shaved off roughly 3 pounds getting the tubes out on this bike. Now I know from the previous test that the stock bike does just over 30 miles an hour on throttle only with everything unlocked. Now the big question is, are tubeless tires noticeably faster? And I have to say the answer is no. They realistically feel about the same, at least as far as our speed on the display. I know the rolling resistance is less and we should get a little more range, possibly a little more speed, but it's not a measurable difference on top speed. If you enjoyed this video on how to convert your Blackbird e-bike to a tubeless setup, then make sure to go check out my other video where I explain electric bike laws in the United States.